The new Ryzen 5000 series processors are here, and today we are going to check out the Ryzen 5 5600X and see how better it is compared to AMD's previous efforts with Ryzen 5 3600, which became the most popular CPU in the mid-range segment and proved itself to be an amazing value for gamers and content creators. And I can tell you that we have some really surprising figures, and I really didn't think that I would get so excited about a mid-range CPU. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and this feels almost too good to be true. AMD's Zen 3 architecture is actually a ground-up redesign over their previous Zen 2 architecture, even while also being on a new 7nm process. The improvements with Zen 3 make AMD's new CPUs achieve a 19% higher instructions per clock, which means that a Zen 3 CPU with the same core count and clock speed as a Zen 2 CPU will be able to do 19% more calculations. This is actually a really big improvement in performance, and before the 15% improvement that the Zen 2 had, we were really seeing way smaller single-digit improvements in industry, and buyers really had to settle for quad-core CPUs even in the mid-range segment. We also have big improvements in the core and cache arrangement on Zen 3, as now there are up to 8 cores per CCX which have access to 32 MB of L3 cache, and this completely eliminates the core-to-core communication latency between CCXs within a die. The Ryzen 5 5600X is a 6-core CPU with 12 threads, and this configuration has really been the sweet spot for the average gamer and even some content creators, and you can see the specs of rest of the CPUs in the lineup in this table. It is also the only CPU that comes with a Wraith cooler in the box, which looks identical to the cooler that came with the 3600, and we are going to check out how good this cooler performs in a later video. So let's get started with our benchmarks, and this is what our test systems are going to be. We are going to test it with an RTX 3080 Tough OC, so we might see a bigger difference in performance compared to what we saw in AMD's tests, which were done with an RTX 2080 Ti. From the Intel side, we have a Core i9-9900K, and even though it's not their latest generation, it is extremely close to their 10700K and 10900K in gaming performance, so we should be able to get a good comparative idea. In Cinebench multi-threaded benchmarks, we see the new hexa-core chip getting close to its 8-core competition while being impressively faster than its predecessor, and this is a trend that we see followed very similarly in POV-Ray multi-core results. But then we start getting to the benchmarks that show the true innovation from AMD, because it has just left the 9900K in the dust with its single core performance. This has been an area where Intel has always had a very slight edge, but now even a 10900K won't be able to get close to the speed of these new Ryzen CPUs. We utilized the hardware acceleration with the NVENC encoder on our RTX 3080, so we saw an extremely close result in our Adobe Premiere Pro tests. Not using hardware encoding may have shown the difference between these CPUs' performance in a better way, like we see in our Blender render tests, but we just thought that it is impractical to not use it. Then moving on to our V-Ray benchmarks, we don't see any surprises, but in our 7-zip compression and decompression tests, we did see the Ryzen 5 5600X beating the 9900K, and this really shows how much heat AMD has turned up on Intel while actually running way cooler in the literal sense, because these new chips are running way cooler than what even a 10900K would run at, as that is still on Intel's 14nm++ process. But it is of course the gaming benchmarks that are extremely exciting with the 5600X, because I really didn't expect that the mid-range CPU in AMD's lineup will completely destroy the 9900K. And again, this situation wouldn't be much different if we had a 10900K here. The results in our Rainbow Six Siege benchmarks really surprised us, as the 5600X hit a totally unexpected average FPS of 659, and we saw a similar lead in the CSGO benchmarks, where Intel has traditionally been ahead. These results are completely game-changing, as the only thing that Intel had over AMD was the technically better gaming performance by a few percent, but AMD has even taken that from them now, which means that there is absolutely no reason to go with an Intel CPU now in any segment whatsoever. Also, make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with bell icon so you don't miss our coverage on the upcoming Radeon 6000 series GPUs. We still saw some titles where the 9900K outperformed the 5600X, but these were some marginal victories, instead of a complete domination that we saw in some wins that AMD had. Overall, in our 8-game average, the 5600X performed 11% better than the 9900K, and compared to the 3600, the 5600X performed 27% better. And that is a jaw-dropping improvement, which is quite close to the 26% improvement that AMD has claimed, even while considering that the 3600X was slightly faster than 3600. We couldn't get the data on power consumption with software, as SW Monitor doesn't support unreleased CPUs, but seeing our data on the total system power draw, it is easy to believe AMD's claims of being 2.4 times more efficient than the competing Intel CPUs. Finally, coming to the price of these CPUs, we had seen the international pricing at the launch of these CPUs, but we also have the Indian pricing now, which is not inclusive of GST, and the Ryzen 5 5600X is going to start at the price of around 23,000 rupees. This is actually significantly higher than the 3600, and as of now, we don't have information on something like a 5600. So this means that we may see some buyers getting older Zen 2 CPUs for productivity purposes, because we can see a very similar price point for a Ryzen 5600X and a 3700X. But it gets very interesting for people who want to buy a CPU for gaming, because even at their higher price point, the Zen 3 CPUs are providing an outstandingly good value, and I think that even something like this 5600X shouldn't seriously bottleneck the higher end GPUs. So this specific CPU could really change the gaming PC market. This also makes it an emergency situation at Intel, because now they have been completely eliminated in all kinds of competitions in all areas. So I really hope that they can get their problems sorted out and can release something that can at least give competition to the red team. Because now, after years of memes and ridicule, I almost feel sad for Intel, and competition is a good thing. But this year has been a really big win for AMD, and while this whole year in general has been filled with negative events, at least the people buying a new PC have access to hardware that provides them great value in all segments. We also don't have information on a new X670 chipset released by AMD, so the existing X570 and B550 series motherboards from all manufacturers will be compatible with these new Zen 3 CPUs. Which is actually really great, because you can get some really amazing deals on some really good X570 motherboards, and I would also like to give a huge shout out to my friend Shatul from CompCraft, who provided us with an ROG Crosshair 8 Hero, which was one of the only 4 X570 motherboards that we could have tested the 5600X with, because we had to use the pre-release BIOS provided by AMD, and this video would really not have been possible without him helping out. So I'll have links to buy these CPUs whenever they become available in the video description. Let me know what you think about AMD and the new Ryzen 5000 series in the comments. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.